always, before you start any makeup application, make sure the skin is clean thoroughly. Start out with your moisturizer. It don't take much. Apply to your face. Wow, this hair is something. Apply to your face and massage your hand. The next thing that you want to do is use a foundation primer. And again, it don't take that much, y'all. A little does go a long way. And you pretty much do the same concept. I like to use a cream liner for whatever reason, and this is in the shade of dark brown. A cream liner to me goes on smooth. Make sure you get your spoolie brush to brush out any wild hair. Shape your brows with the dark brown liner. Let's do the same thing for both. My brows need to be arched, but I'm trying to let them go out a little, so I'm just pretty much filling in what's there for right now, but they're definitely going to be shaped. Take the liner and kind of lightly fill those in with the liner as well. Again, this is my preference. If there's another method that you like to use, be my guest. Next, I will be using a product that I marketed, which is a gel brow. And this is like a gel pomade. You get your brush and just apply this on top of your brows. And then you want to do it again. This product is available for purchase. If you like. By using this product, it actually shades your brows in darker. However, you want that more natural look. I do have a product in same gel form, but it isn't a lot of brown. Pretty much do the same concept to both brows. Close view. Again, you make sure you just keep the guideline up how far the brow go out cool brush again and pretty much blend it out. Next, you just want to take some products that you have left over and just kind of blend the inner brows. I like to use my Pro concealer. And this is in the shade lighter than my skin tone. Get your angle brush to apply the concealer. And using the concealer, it helps for the brow gel not to move. And it also gives you a very chic look. Again, this can be a preference. You can also use your foundation shade to do this method as well. Okay, where is my foundation? Okay, this is the full foundation coverage, and I will be applying this on the top of my brows. I definitely want the top of my brows to be the shade of my skin, so I will be applying, instead of the concealer, I will be using the foundation shade on top. You pretty much just outline your brows with shade of foundation. You can also use the shade of concealer if you would like. But because I have to use foundation on my face anyway, I just decided to outline lines with the shade of foundation that I will be using for my face. And again, this gives you a chic look. I'm taking the Pro Concealer and just pretty much dabbing this across my eyelid. And it just purple my eyes for the eyeshadow. This step can be skipped if you would like, but I just don't like to waste product, so the product that I have left, I go ahead and apply that. Now I'm using the Urban Decay eyeshadow base. again, this is also covering my eyes with the eyeshadow. You just apply this to your eyes, eyelid, and blend this out. Next, this is another product that I am marketing. This is the Paddle Brow. And anytime you use any kind of like liquid, gel, or cream, you definitely want to set it with a paddle. Again, this step can be out, but to do that, for your brows and to also to make them last longer, I like to use the brow powder to cover that. Next, I'm going to use the light color to blend in the center brows. And they just help you your natural blend. You will take your brush and you will kind of lightly blend it out. Definitely on the line. So to avoid the harsh line, just kind of blend it out. Now these two products I'm about to use, and these are minimal shimmery powder, which can be used in different ways. It's also a product that I'm marketing. This can be used on your face as well as your body. And you pretty much want to just tap this on using a lightly fluffy brush, and you just tap it on and kind of blend it the second time. Again, I'm going for a natural, so I want to be able to see the colors. So by tapping it on, you're keeping the color visible. Next, I'm going with a little bit darker shade, and this is almost in a rose gold color. And you do the same concept. Oh, I'm sorry, this is more in the orange. Shade. And these products can be purchased been using this product and playing as you go in a circle motion. Half off in the excess product. You definitely don't want to waste anything. Now we'll go in with my blending brush and just go in and define and blend. And again, this is a more soft look. I definitely want no harsh lines. Next, I'll be using that blue that I was applied to the outer corners of the eyes, and I was going to pat that on. And I will pat it on and blend it into the two other colors I just applied. The tip to this is, if you want your color to look more vibrant, you will actually pat it on and to blend, you will use a separate motion. Do this process very lightly because you definitely want to keep your product visible. You don't want to go in and remove your products. So definitely do this lightly in the circular motion. Now I want to add some glitter or to my brow bone and this is Reflex by MAC and I would just add some highlight right underneath the brow bone as well as in the teardrop. And this color gives you a, you know, depending on what the light hits your face at, you reflect and sparkle from the color. I love, love. You want to go in and blend that than it is. I want to just tap in places. I don't want to remove any of the color. I just want to blend it out. So I'm pretty much just tapping. Next, I will be using a liquid liner, and for whatever reason, and again, this is just a preference, I like to apply my liquid liner before and after I apply my strip lashes. To me, it gives you a more natural look than just applying lashes without a liner. You can use a cream liner or you can use a liquid liner. For this process, I like to use the liquid liner. And again, these are just my preference. Do what you like best. I'm now applying the lash glue to my lashes. And these are the ones I had on previously before, so I didn't remove all the lash glue like I should have. So this is what I'm doing right now. So definitely always remove any excess glue. You have worn these before. Sometimes I'm just taking my tweezers and removing any excess glue from my lashes. Be careful because you don't want to remove the hair. And if you've been following me, then you know that I like to stretch my eyes out when I apply my lashes. So, and it kind of helped me, or helped the lashes to glide on easily. So it make it very easy to apply the lashes, in my opinion, when you stretch the eye out. Or stretch the skin. Now pretty much the same concept to the other eye. Again, y'all, I'm just basically removing any lash glue that was on my lashes. And if you need to bend them to shape them, then do so. Just pull your skin back towards your hairline and position the lashes above your natural lashes. Pretty much open your eyes, make sure they're on good or they're in the right position. Use your tweezers to adjust anything that needs to be adjusted. before the glue dries. And there you have it. Again, like I said before, I like to apply my liquid liner after I have finished applying the lashes as well. Now I'm basing this in a cream black liner. To outline my waterline. And the full coverage foundation I used earlier to line out my brows will be the same foundation that I'm using all over my face. Again, y'all, this is my shade of color, so I don't have to necessarily do a customized blend. If you don't have the correct shade, you definitely need to do a formulator that will give you your correct shade. And this is full cover. So you can face a body over your whole face. And doing this on your eyes, forehead. Very important to get them out. And sometimes, depending on what you are wearing, it's very important also to get the top of your chest. Because I'm not doing any contouring. I'm just going to go in with a setting powder. Or as you can see, I'm about to use the same palette that I used before. Underneath the lower lashes. Back in with your shimmery powder and you apply that as well to the teardrop and kind of blend it out. And now you go in with your setting powder. And this is from MAC Cosmetics. And you just pat. Cream foundation. I have to put it in the So basically you just want to take the shimmery powder and then you can use this as a highlight. Highlighter and add this above your cheeks. And me personally, I like to add just some to the tip of the nose and kind of rub this in. You see that light, you see the glitz from the highlight. Get your fan brush and just blend this out. And I use my fingers to kind of blend it out on the tip of my nose. And sometimes I like to use the fan brush as well. Because I want a more softer look. I'm not going with that contouring of the face. And this is some glitter rose gold from MAC. And before you put this on, I would like to use the CarMax to moisturize your lips. And then I go in and add the glitter. Again, this is from MAC Cosmetics, and you can use this. Actually, it's made to use on the eyes, but I tend to use a little on the lips as well. And I put my drug this in. Now I'm looking for my favorite lip gloss. Rub it in. Now you just want to add the lip gloss to the outer lips on the side. So this lip gloss can also be purchased . Next thing you want to use is your setting spray. You definitely want to be able to set everything you just applied to your face. And there you have it. So what I'm about to do now is taking my hair down and give you the final look. And I am definitely loving this wig, y'all. I will post the details about this wig in the description box. So yes, this is the final look. For cooking, I I do travel. You visit me on my website at www.bambobshell.com. And until next time, y'all, y'all know what to do. Like it.